I was surfing the internet looking for some good content when YouTube recommended to me Boris coding videos, and for some reason I decided to watch them again. But during my watching, I always ask myself, why Boris, the glorious Slav, making these easy programs using Western programming languages, while we have our true Slavic one? YoptaScript. This video I'm gonna create a cool gopnik game using this YoptaScript, and I'm gonna prove you that our true Slavic programming language is not worse than your shitty Western Java and Python. Yeah, basically YoptaScript is just some kind of a translation of another Western programming language called JavaScript. But I guess we're gonna let this moment pass. So, YoptaScript. To start coding on this blatiful Slavic language, you will need two things. Since, as I said before, this language is Slavic, of course you, блять, need Russian keyboard on your Windows. As you can see, I already have it, cause I'm Slav. Then you have to download YoptaScript itself from their website. When you download the zip file, I recommend you to unpack it into some new empty folder. Okay, among all of that shit, all you actually need is just this one little file. Copy it into your main folder and then delete everything else нахуй. Nice. Our gopnik game will be in browser, so now you have to create empty HTML file. If you open this file, your default browser should open. Охуенно, of course, but still it doesn't really look like a cool Slavic game. At this moment, we actually have to start coding. Of course, you can code even your default notepad, but come on, it looks like shit. And ой, бля, it doesn't even have dark mode. Shortly, I recommend you to install Microsoft Visual Code. 50 megabytes only, but just take a look at that legit design. You probably already feel yourself like a true programmer. Okay, now let me quickly explain you basics of HTML. Long story short, HTML is just a shit ton of words which are understandable for browser. Every word is some kind of a container, which keeps another words, which are some kind of a containers as well. Sounds retarded, I know, but let's just take a look at the example and you will understand anything. The main container we will need today is body. It literally contains everything on a page. You may be a bit curious what a пиздец I've just wrote. And trust me, everything is simple. Every HTML word has to be in a triangle brackets, because блять, it doesn't matter actually, just type any HTML word inside triangle brackets and everything will work perfect. Why have I typed body two times and second time with slash? First body means that I opened container, and second one means that I closed it. And those slash actually says that this container is closed. Ебать, simple, isn't it? Before we actually start to coding, let me explain the logic of our future game. And by the way, show you some prototype of our future web page in special software. Here it is. So we have some page with score. Let's type it. Score. Besides score, we have some gopnik. Of course, gopnik always squad. Here it is. Gopnik, ебать. And besides gopnik and score, we have randomly generated семка. As we know, when gopnik fills семку, he immediately wants to get it. Like, here is gopnik logic. And since we will be playing by self-respected gopnik, our duty is to get this семка. And by getting this семка, our score will be increased on 1. So the only thing we have to do in this game is just to try to get this семка. When we get it, our score is increased, and семка, блять, and семка spawns in some different place, and then we have to go over there. Блять, I don't know, genius. So to embody our gopnik game, we will actually need only two HTML tags. Look, семка and gopnik is just an ordinary texture, which means it is just an ordinary image. And the score is just an ordinary text. Блять, easy. So now all that we need is just to find gopnik and семка texture. And trust me guys, I have no problems with gopnik pics. Just you can check any of my video and you will understand me. Perfect one. So now we have to find only семка texture. Ебать, perfect. Okay, now we have our main textures, but now we have to remove the background from Гопник and Семка. I guess Photoshop would help me out with it.
One eternity later.
Done, ебать. Let's get into coding. Okay, let's create our image container. It called img. Unfortunately, HTML doesn't know which pic we want to use for which container. So we have to tell him using src property. To set this property, all we have to do is type in brackets src equal to double quotes and type our texture name, in this case Гопник png. So let's save our index.html file.
На нахуй!
And open it. Заебись. Now let's do the same thing, but with Семка. Блять. Yeah. But actually I would prefer to see Гопник a bit right from Семка, so let's do it. Let's use style property for it. And we'll say that position of this peak would be absolute, which means that it would be located directly in some points on the screen. In my case, that would be 500 pixels from the left and 0 pixels from top. And Семка would be just in the top left corner. Let's check it out. Perfectly, guys. So the only thing we have to do is to add some score in our game. Let's type it. Let's create a simple container with text. It calls label in HTML. This text will show how many Семкас we have already gained. Default score is 0. So now, if you want to program all of the shit, we have to give each of that word an ID to manipulate it using YoptaScript. We can do it using ID property in our HTML word. Now we have to include those YoptaScript file in our project. Just type in body container next string, and everything will work perfectly. Next step, we have to create script container, where we will gonna make our script, блять, sounds logical. Yeah, don't forget to tell to our project that you are TrueSwap by typing language equal YoptaScript. Let's check out if anything actually works fine by writing in our script shooter YoptaScript works. At this moment, you may have some problem, in case we don't know Russian, of course. To help you with it, I'm gonna show you in English how to read those illegible Slavic manuscripts and tell you what they actually mean. In case you are some kind of a masochist and you actually want to code in YoptaScript on your own, I feel like that you will actually face the problem of absence of Slavic letters on your keyboard. Western spy. But don't be sad, comrade. I have a good old solution of that problem. Just print picture of Slavic keyboard, ебать. Genius, isn't it?
Блять. О нет. Опа. Найс.
Окей, let's get back to our code. Шухер? Блять, actually, I have no idea how to translate it. Гопникс usually say шухер when someone pops up while they do something illegal. In our case, if YoptaScript works fine, on our screen will pops up a message that YoptaScript is actually works fine. Фух, блять. Okay, guys, main part of our game is done. Our Slavic programming language works perfectly. And in the next video, we're gonna actually finish our script. Trust me, it's much easier than you think. So, guys, don't forget to subscribe and click that bell button to not miss the next part, If you didn't understand something in this video, feel free to ask me in the comments. I will definitely 100% answer you. In case you are genius and you understood anything, just share your impressions in comments. Please just, type something, I beg you. I worked really hard on this one, so, please just don't forget to smash that like button. Really appreciate it. Ваня has been with you. Have a blatiful day.